Sleep is just another victim of human arrogance that we're above the grubby world of biology. We're not.
That is Russell Foster, director of the Sleep and Circadian Neuroscience Institute at the University of Oxford.
We have become industrial creatures in the past, 200 years, and most rapidly since the 1950s, with the massive commercialization of cheap light at night through electric light. We've invaded the night, and in the process, we've abandoned sleep. So we're fighting against, you know, millions and certainly hundreds of thousands of years of evolutionary biology, which has embraced sleep. I mean, it's really interesting to think how sleep was considered in the medieval period.
Historical records suggest that in many parts of the medieval world, a segmented pattern of sleep was the norm. People essentially slept in two shifts. The first would last for a couple of hours, and then you'd get up and maybe do some work, or eat, or drink, or pray, have sex, visit with the neighbors, whatever. And in English, this period of the night was sometimes called the watch. Then you'd go back to bed for a second, longer sleep till morning. Historically, sleep has been prized, says Russell. In the Elizabethan era, people were practically writing love poems about it.
Just think of Shakespeare, the honey-heavy dew of slumber. Sleep, sleep, nature's soft nurse, have thy forsaken thee. We intuitively seem to embrace sleep.
But wait a minute, because, I mean, Shakespeare, hold on. Macbeth is an insomniac, right? His wife is a sleepwalker. Falstaff has sleep apnea. The guy with the best take, right, on sleep is Hamlet as he's contemplating suicide. Like, everybody wants it and nobody's getting it. It seems that was true even in Shakespeare's time.
Absolutely. But they realized that if they weren't getting it, they were in trouble. And now we actively fight against it.